Welcome to Ahluwar's channel. In this tutorial, we are going to see how to do Mickey and Minnie Beanie. Okay, this one I have already done just to show you how our end product will be. Okay, for this we have to do normal standard beanie, which we have already done in a separate tutorial. I'll share the link in the description. You can do the normal standard beanie like this. 10 rounds of normal 10 rounds of normal beanie in black, and two rounds in red, and finally a single crochet round, just like we have done it in the standard beanie tutorial. Okay, so after this we have to make 2 ears, right, for Mickey Beanie. But I have done the ears already. I'll show you how to do the ears in white color, because let's face it, black will not be clearly visible. Okay, so we'll just do how to make the ears. Okay, we'll be doing this with magic circle. We have already done a tutorial in magic circle, but I'll show you here also. Roll over the two loops, have the back long tail at the back end. Okay, now insert, pull this up and do a chain. Now we have secured our magic circle. Okay, now chain one more chain, do 10 double crochets in the ring. Okay, as you see, I have done two different sizes of the beanie, right? This is I have done for my son's birthday. It's a Mickey Mouse theme, so this is for him, and this is for my daughter, who is just 3 months old. So I have done in two different sizes. Okay, you can also do the size variation is also described in the beanie tutorial. Okay, so for this also you can do two different types, different size of ears. You can see this is a bigger ear and this is a smaller ear, right? I'll show you how to do both of them. Okay, now do 10 double crochets in the same ring. Okay, how many I have done so far? One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Right, now pull this up and slip stitch into the first stitch with the tail end inside the stitch. Okay, you should not, because we have not done any knot till now, so this tail end should not be fastened off. It has to be keep in the stitch. Okay, so for the smaller ear, what I have done is I have done two half double crochets in each stitch, and I have completed the round. Okay, see, only two rounds are there. I have done one round of double crochet and one round of half double crochet, that is two in each stitch. For this bigger ear, what I have done, I have done two rounds of double crochets and finally one round of half double crochet, right? So as I already told, for the second round, if you are making a bigger ear, you have to do one round of half double crochet again. So otherwise, if you are making smaller ear, you have to do only half double crochet. But in the second round, always we'll be doing two in each stitch. Okay, either, no matter what you do, either double crochet or half double crochet, you have to do two stitches in the same stitch. Okay, so in the first round we have 10 stitches, so in the second round we'll be having 20 stitches. Okay, like this. If you are making for this, I have chained only one and start doing the half double crochet. If you are doing bigger ear, then you have to do chain one, chain two, then double crochet, two double crochets in each stitch. Okay, So for bigger ear we will be doing 3 rounds total. For smaller ear we will be doing only 2 rounds, 1 double crochet and 1 half double crochet. Okay, so now I'm showing you. If you are making a Mickey beanie, it's always good to make a bigger ear, okay, because in Mickey beanie the point of attraction is nothing but the ears, okay. But if you are making a mini beanie, you can do it's up to you. If you want to make a bigger one, you can do, but you can also make a smaller one, okay. But for Mickey, always make the bigger one, okay, because in mini beanie we can we'll be attaching the bow also, so the ears will be pretty much covered, right? So no matter which size ears we will be making, okay. So if you are making mini, then if you're making Mickey, I suggest to make the bigger one, okay. See, I have completed the second round with 2 stitches in each. Then slip stitch, now don't slip stitch into the chain 2, slip stitch into the first stitch, okay. Now in order to make the border stiff, we have to do the third round, okay. Third round you can either do single crochet or half double crochet, it's up to you, okay. But in the third round you have to do 1 2 1 2, like that. So one single crochet in the first stitch, 2 single crochet in the next stitch. So that's how you don't get the wavy ear, but at the same time it will not be a shrunken one, okay. It's the same increase like in the beanie, okay. So 1 2 1 2 1 2, right? So since we have started with 10 stitches, in the last third round we'll be having 30 stitch, okay, and then in the last stitch we'll be having 2 stitches. That's how we'll be knowing we have done it, we have completed the sequence correctly, okay. So I have 2 stitch remaining. I'll be doing 1 and 2 stitches in the last stitch. So now the sequence is completed. Now you have to slip stitch into the first stitch and leave a long tail, okay, like this, so that this will be used to stitch in the beanie, okay. So like this you can do bigger ear and smaller ear, as I already told, 1 double crochet and 1 half double crochet row, okay. So now we will stitch our ear in the beanie, okay. Take the yarn needle, insert. If you see Mickey beanie, the ears will be exactly up on the head, no big difference. So what I have done is I have skipped 1 and 2 rounds, and I have stitched the ear in 3 and 4 rounds, okay, 3rd and 4th round. So like the same way we'll be, I'll show you how to do this. Okay, skip the first and second round. For mini beanie, this I am going to make as a mini beanie. For mini beanie, since we'll be attaching a bow, you can always use 4th and 5th, but it will be good if you use only 3 and 4. Okay, so make sure your ear is on the right side. You see, this is the wrong side and this is the right side, right? So see, 1 2 3 4. So I'll be using the third and fourth round here. So I'll attach the yarn here, and in the fourth round I will insert. Okay, so in these three rounds I'll be using 5 stitches. Okay, so I'll be using 1 2 3 4 5 stitches, and I'll insert and take out in every stitch. Okay, I have used only third and fourth round. So in order to complete this, we have to make a knot. See, insert it here and tighten this up. Make one more knot too, just to secure. Because why we have the long tail here? Because if not, if you detach it here and use a separate yarn to stitch the ear, then you will have to make two knots in the starting as well as in the ending. But here, since it's already attached to the ear, we don't need to worry about this end. We need to make a knot only at the one end. Okay, so it's always better to leave a long tail while fasten the ear and use that for stitching. Okay, so now you can insert this inside the ears and you can fasten this off. Okay, like the same way, stitch this ear also in this side, so that when we attach a bow, both the ear and the bow will be visible. Okay, this bow we have already done a tutorial. I'll share the link of that tutorial also in the description. So make this, and then we will easily make a mini beanie. Okay, so finally, when we have to do, what we have to do is to make this buttons. Okay, this one you can use a button also instead of making this in a yarn. But when we attach a button here, we will be attaching only in the center, so it tends to come off. Okay, so I prefer in making the yarn button. Okay, so it's just a simple button. For Mickey beanie you need only 2. For mini beanie what you need is 4, because we need to attach 2 here and 2 in the bow, one on each side. Okay, I'll show you how to make a button. Okay, okay, again now also we'll be doing the magic circle, but instead of half double crochet we will be having half double crochet. Okay, so yarn over, insert the second loop from the back, chain one and make 10 half double crochet. Okay, 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10. Right, we have done 10 half double crochet. Pull this out completely and tightly.
Yes, thank you.
Okay, don't cut this off because we have not done any knot so far. We need this to make a knot at the end after stitching. So make the tail, keep the tail end untouched. Slip stitch into the first stitch. It will be tighter, but make sure you have taken both the loops, right? So insert and pull the loop up. Make this keep this untouched and chain one and leave with the long tail because we need both the tail ends to stitch around and make a knot. Okay. Right, so this is how we have we'll be making a button. So if you are making Mickey beanie, you need two buttons. If you are making mini beanie, you need four buttons, two for here and two for here. Okay, I'll show you how to attach one button and the rest I'll attach off camera. Okay, so make sure your ear is in the same line as in the button. Okay, so this is the wrong side, this is the right side. Okay, so now keep it here. The main point is the ear end and the button should be in the same line. Okay, so keep it here. Insert your hook in all the stitches. So that's how your button will not be having any unnecessary gap. Okay. See, I am inserting and pulling out in every stitch. All the 10 stitches we need to stitch with the tail end. Okay, like the same way we need to stitch the button in the bow also for mini beanie. If you are making Mickey, don't worry about the bow. I'm sorry about the noise. Now, since we have reached at the end, right, insert it into the first stitch again to complete the circle, and this also make sure it in the back side. And when we have two tail ends for making a knot, we can easily make this one secure. Okay, you understand why we have not cut the end and why we have a long tail end at the both the sides also, right? So now we'll be making a knot and keep it safe. Okay, so I'll attach two more buttons here and I'll attach the bow as well as the ear, and I'll show you how the beanie turns out. Okay, if you can attach the bow either in three places, in center, okay, and one end in this ear and the other end in this ear. Okay, so I'll attach it and show it how it turned out. See, I've stitched all the buttons in the hat as well as the bow. Okay, you can stitch the button with both the sides, but when you stitch the bow in the hat, don't use this first one, because when you use it, then it will be shrunken and the stitch in the stitch, and it won't look good. Okay, so when you do the stitch, only use the back side. Okay, in both, let the front side be free. And when you do the center stitch, you can always use the loop what we have already done. Okay, so this is how the Mickey and Minnie beanie will be done. As I already told, you can use the button if you want, but I don't want a button in my children's hat, so that's why I used the crochet buttons. Okay, so I hope you like this video. Try it out, it's very simple and very beautiful. Okay, the only thing, the color itself speaks for itself. So try it and share your pictures in our group. Subscribe to the channel so that you never miss any video. If you like this video, comment, share and like. Thank you. Bye bye.